Oh, no.
Every time you turn up, something monumental and terrible happens. I don't think I have the stomach for it.
No drama this time, Raziel.
You are persistent, crossing time like this to follow me. Still waiting for that coin of yours to land on its edge.
I'm biding my time. I see that Mobius has played a little trick on you.
Yes. He clearly doesn't want me to meet this Janos Ordrin.
Perhaps. Or maybe he merely hoped that it would harden your heart against me to see this wasteland which I single-handedly authored.
My heart doesn't need hardening, Cain. If I even suspected that destroying you would make any difference, I would do it this instant.
I knew you'd see through them, Raziel. Janos is indeed the key to your destiny. But you'll need to find your own way back into Nosgoth's path. Make no mistake, though, Raziel. You and I are now in great danger. We are irritants here. Malevolent forces are being marshaled to eliminate us.
You talk as though we're allies.
Regardless of your sentiments, Raziel, in their eyes, we are.
Well, they're certainly trying to eliminate you, King. There can be no doubt of that. I am assaulted relentlessly with demands for your demise. Whatever it is that you're plotting, they're scared to death of you. As for me, I suspect they made a grave error when they allowed my unique resurrection. I don't think they know how to destroy me.
You mustn't underestimate them, Raziel.
And who exactly is this diabolical they to which we keep referring? If there's some grand conspiracy going on, the right hand doesn't appear to know what the left is doing. Even Mobius seems to be caught out at every turn.
Mobius is a puppet, Raziel. Haven't you realized that yet? That's the sweetest irony in all of this. Nosgoth's great manipulator is their plaything. But the ones pulling the strings haven't shown their faces yet.
They don't like us unwriting their carefully choreographed history, though, do they?
You must understand, Raziel, we haven't unwritten history, we've merely rewritten it. The future flows around our petty actions, finding the path of least resistance while admitting only the slightest alterations. This is the reshuffling you felt when you refused to kill me. And remember, Raziel, we are irritants in this regard as well. History will not allow the introduction of a paradox.
And if events cannot be reshuffled to accommodate the change?
It is the irritant who's expelled. Bear in mind that this may be exactly the outcome our enemies are trying to provoke. We must tread very carefully.
Prepare to die.
The scenes I discovered here were unambiguous. This race of winged beings, the architects of the pillars and the creators of the Reaver, were Nosgoth's first vampires. Their bloodthirst appeared to be a curse inflicted upon them by their vanquished enemies. These images confirmed the truths that Cain had divulged to me, but I had been too incredulous to accept. I struggled in vain to see how the pieces fit together, how Cain intended to escape the dilemma of his destiny, and what role he had plotted for me, and why Mobius and the dark powers with which he seemed to be allied were so desperate to see Cain dead, and so intent on me being the instrument of his execution. As the Reaver drained the forge of its vital energy, the tempest receded. I recovered myself and paused to admire my newly forged weapon, now imbued with the elemental power of air. Thus armed, I hoped that I now finally possess the means to escape this wasted land. This elemental reaver I discovered had the power to obliterate barriers that were cracked or compromised. At last, I had the means to open that ruined time-streaming chamber I discovered so long ago in the swamp. Now, perhaps, I could leave this wasteland and return to an era when Janos Ordrin still lived. had no choice but to act purely on blind faith. There was no way to tell what error this device was tuned to, and I had neither the knowledge nor the means to set the machine myself. I hesitated only briefly. Then, throwing the switch, I hurled myself into oblivion and relinquished my will to the hand of fate. Beyond all hope and against all probability, it seemed that the device had unerringly delivered me to the error I sought. For these were Seraphan banners, and these vampires apparently the victims of their crusade. The coincidence seemed too convenient to naively ascribe to fate, but whether my opportune arrival had been orchestrated by Mobius, some other influence, I didn't know. If Janos Ordrin still lived, I would find him. But I was wary of further deception and resolved to tread carefully.